Hello there, welcome to my everyday makeup routine. When I wear makeup, which isn't every day, it's always minimal. My routine never strays from being quick and easy, 5 to 10 minutes, and full of cream products to blend with my fingers. I wear this kind of natural look to work, a day out, a night out, all the time really. There are some holy grail products that never change, but the elements I switch up most are cheeks, lips, and eyes. Cream colour is most fun to play with for me, adding subtle pops of colour. No morning skincare routine, I do my main steps at night, so I just splash my face with water, then apply these two. I've been in a long-term relationship with Glossier Priming Moisturiser, spanning about 10 to 12 tubes. It's my favourite, super light, almost fluid, hydrating, plumping, smoothing, dewy starting point. Then I add sunscreen every single day. Now, I never use language on my channel like, you'll love this, you need this, but sunscreen is the one thing I'll tell you you need to be wearing. Cannot stress its importance enough, both for vanity, preventing signs of aging, and for the incredibly serious matter of skin cancer. Maybe as an Australian, I'm more aware of it, but we're literally talking life and death here, so please put sunscreen on every morning, whatever the weather. And when it's as good as this one, you'll even enjoy it. My all-time favourite Mecca Cosmetica to Save Face SPF 50 is as hydrating as a moisturiser and lightweight with a glowy finish. SPF perfection. You'll notice there are no base products here. I don't wear or own foundation, just never liked how it looked on my skin because zero coverage is enough for me. I usually only wear tinted moisturiser, but for the last 7 months or so, I haven't even worn that either. I'm really happy with my skin, so I just prefer to let it show. But I will use a little bit of concealer where needed to brighten and cover any blemishes. Chanel Eclat Lumiere is my favourite for under the eyes. It brightens up your complexion and is really light and easy to blend. More seamless than YSL Touche Eclat in my opinion. Then Clé de Peau Concealer is unparalleled for me. I'm not someone who goes base free then covers their face in concealer. I'll literally dot this on exactly where needed to pinpoint conceal occasional spots. It's my holy grail because it's high coverage but still so creamy and blends naturally into the skin. An investment, but these last for such a long time. I have quite bold, full brows anyway, so only need a quick touch up to define them with Charlotte Tilbury Brow Lift. There's a spoolie and a brow bone highlight, but I'm only interested in the pencil. You could stroke this on to mimic individual hairs, but I just lightly shade all over the brow to tint it very slightly. Then the famous Glossier Boy Brow, which has been a constant in my routine for years. Creamy, pigmented, plenty of hold so your brows don't move, but the formula's comfortable so they never feel crunchy. I always used to skip bronzer, but two recent discoveries meant I've enjoyed adding a little bit into my routine. The Milk Makeup Matte Bronzer in Baked is a new favourite cream formula. Super easy to draw the stick straight onto the skin, and the light creamy texture disappears when you blend with fingers. Adds really nice warmth and has a slightly dewy finish. RMS Beauty brought out these brand new luminizing powders in February. I first saw this at dinner with Rosemary Swift last October, then she sent them to me in December and I've loved playing with Madeira bronzer ever since. It's designed to be a luminous bronzer. No glitter, just a beautiful light-catching glow that looks so healthy and sun-kissed. I dust this on very, very lightly with a Real Techniques buffing brush, but it's gorgeous smudged on as an eyeshadow too. I'll be showing you the other shades in a video soon. Cream blush, my favourite bit. Recently I've been obsessed with Clé de Peau Shade 4 Perfect Peach, and it's pretty much perfect. So light it's almost mousse-like with a lovely luminosity that makes your cheeks look lit from within. This is actually what Rosie Huntington-Whiteley had on her cheeks at this year's Vanity Fair Oscar party. Then the slightest touch of highlighter, usually RMS. She invented the subtle, lit-from-within look, and the shade Champagne Rosé kinda beats the original Living Luminizer for me. Glossy and glowy, so I pat a tiny bit of this onto my cheekbones or eyes, and the hint of pink really suits my skin tone. You might have seen this eyeshadow pop up in my 2018 makeup favourites. I can't go past Tom Ford's Cream and Powder Eye Colour in Golden Peach. It has a super glittery powder on top, but I only use the soft, moussey cream underneath. A pitch-perfect peach that's so radiant, smudge it all over the eye and you're done. Miranda Kerr wore this on her wedding day, so that's a big tick too. Then my good old Chanel Le Volume Mascara. It's really the only one I've used for years because it adds definition, length, and lots of volume without ever looking heavy or clumpy. You just look like you have really good lashes. In summer, I reach for lipstick more on nights out and stick to sheer or tinted balms during the day. The Fresh Sugar Tinted Lip Treatments have appeared on my channel before and will again, showing you new shades I picked up last year. Spice is a warm, peachy orange that can be left low-key or layered. Just a really easy one to throw on without a mirror. That's what's in my makeup bag. My trusty black cosmetic case from The Daily Edited always has products being swapped in and out of it, but these are the usual elements that make up my relaxed but put-together vibe. I'd love to hear what's in your bag of tricks and if you're a minimal makeup lover too. It's always been the only style for me, but I love hearing from so many of you who've given it a go for the first time and haven't looked back. Thanks for watching. See you next time.